Hi guys, in this video we discuss how to check microwave link performance in NEC IDU. So first click on refresh button to check if any alarm active. If there is no alarm active, so we click on event log to check previously active alarm. Now here you can check different alarm active previously at different date and different time. So we need to check link performance because link performance may affect due to these alarms. Different alarm here, audio, CPU, cable open, frame ID and other UAE, different type of alarm, so we need to check the performance for it. For link performance, click on PMON report, then modem PMON report. Now different modem showing here. As we check all alarms on slot 3 and some on slot 4, so we check performance for slot 3 and slot 4. As you also see here, for one day interval different error counting, so we click on slot 3. Now showing here last 3 dates we can check each 15 minute interval, and all other date we can just check here all the error if counting. So we click on first date. Here you can check each 15 minute interval available for one complete day, and all the error count showing here if any. You can see from last two interval there is some error count, so we also check for previous date. As all the errors count is zero, so no performance error on link. If some count showing, so there must be a performance issue, so need to be rectified according to alarms. Similarly, you can check for modem at slot 4. As it is XPIC link, so need to be checked for both. Here you can also see from last 3 intervals some error count showing, so it's need to be rectified. Similarly, you can check performance report also from far end, and also all the alarm from far end. In PMON report tab, there is another option available for E1 PMON report, STM1 PMON report and Ethernet PMON report, and also VLAN counter report. You can also check a required PMON report from here. As no E1 and STM1 interface here, so no data available for it. In Ethernet PMON report, you can see here data available for last 15 minutes and one day. There not should be any RX drop events, RX undersized packets and RX fragments. There all should be zero. As you can see here, all counts are zero, so no performance error on Ethernet. That's all for the video. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe.